student, welcome to today's lesson. Student, in our last lesson, we had seen bacterial classification, ecology in the use of bacteria on ecosystem, and we had seen bacterial genetic modification. We are going to see viruses. Under this lesson, we will see viral classification, viral multiplication, HIV/AIDS. Students, at the end of this lesson, we will be able to explain virus and its multiplication. Students, do you know what are viruses? Well then, the very controversial thing is to biologists is virus. Still, biologists are found under controversy. Two group virus, under prokaryotic, under living, under eukaryotic. But they arrive at a conclusion as it is found as a boundary between living and non-living. So, virus is neither living nor prokaryotic and eukaryotic. But outside living cell, virus is considered as a particle, which we call viral. All viral particle outside a living cell contain the following two components, which is viral protein, which we call capsid, and viral genetic material. The key thing that assimilate virus with that of the eukaryotic organism is the presence of genetic material, where viral genetic material is not both DNA and RNA. But virus contain either RNA or DNA, but not both. Some virus may contain membrane outside their protein coat, and some may be secrete enzyme inside this protein coat capsid. Student, do you think that virus are capable to metabolize independently of the host cell? Well, you say no, it is good, because there is no most organelle found in the living cell virus unable to metabolize independently. To be carried out metabolism, they need a host. By that, all viruses are a parasite. All viruses are a parasite. They need a host to be attached themselves to and capable to enter into that of the host to start their metabolic activity. The one critical metabolism that they can carry out is reproduction. When they enter or that to get their host, they can carry out their metabolism, unless virus is considered as a particle, the one that we call viral. Well then, this is structure of virus, the one that we call, this structure may be RNA or DNA, but not both. If it contains RNA, we call RNA virus. If it contains DNA, we call DNA virus. As that of eukaryotic cell, no virus contains both DNA and RNA at the same time. There is a protein coat outside of this one, where some virus contain enzyme at the inner side of this protein coat, and some may be contain membrane outside of this protein coat. there is an enzyme secretion inside of this one, and again some may be contained this one or membrane outside of this protein coat. But all viral particles contain genetic material in the protein coat in common. Another, it is too difficult to classify a virus, but based on two main features, we can classify a virus. The one criteria important to classify viruses based on their genetic material, the way their genetic material can be expressed. The way their genetic material expressed shows a mutation or variability. Accordingly, based on the genetic material they can contain, we can classify virus into three. One is DNA virus. If they contain DNA in the genetic material, we call them said to be DNA virus. For example, herpes simplex virus, a virus that carries cold sores. And again, the way they can express DNA, RNA, viral protein enzyme. Whereas the ends that contain, if they contain RNA as genetic material, we call the asset to be RNA virus. For example, a virus that causes swine flu virus. End virus, if they contain RNA as genetic material and express differently in different way, we call it is said to be retrovirus. A virus that causes HIV can be grouped under this one. Student, let me show you a brief difference between RNA virus and retrovirus. Here, when we say RNA virus, they simply express this RNA into that of a viral protein. A viral protein. When we call RNA virus, retrovirus, they contain RNA in the genetic material, but express in different way, which become form in this one. The only organ that can express the genetic material in this manner is retrovirus. Whereas RNA virus become expressed simply RNA into that of the protein and that of enzyme, whereas retrovirus express from RNA to that of DNA to that of RNA, and then after viral protein in that of enzyme. Another criteria how virus can be classified is based on what type of organism that they can parasitize. If a virus parasitizes an animal, we say it is said to be animal parasitizing virus. If it parasitizes plant, we call it is said to be plant parasitizing virus. If it parasitizes bacteria, we say it is said to be bacteria parasitizing virus. This is the structure of bacteria infecting virus. The commonly studied type of virus is bacteriophage. Bacteriophage is a bacteria infecting virus. It can have two sides. There is a head region here, there is a tail region here. Over the tail region to contain genetic material, and again there is a presence of protein coat too. There is a protein coat and again genetic material, and again over the tail fiber one there is a tail. About 6 fiber can be found here. This is the structure of bacteriophage or a virus that infects bacteria. It is highly stable one. Well, when we see a multiplication of this bacteriophage, it may be reproduced in this manner. One is by lytic means. When we say lytic cycle, it involves lytic system. Once a virus becomes in contact with the respective host, it can breast the host cell, killing of the host cell, lysing or breakdown of the host cell, to be release a viral particle at once to infect another host cell. Entry by endocytosis means, and again release out to infect another host cell by killing the host lighting means lights break or burst of the host cell. Whereas lysogenetic to mean once a viral particle become incorporated their genetic material into host genome, into host bacterial genome, this genome can be continued for many generations until certain condition maintained. This phase may be remain dormant for many generations if certain factor become maintained. If factor become maintained, it may be converted to that the infective one and converting that of lytic means. Simply, incorporation or that of integration of viral genetic material into host genome that can remain for many generations, that can continue for many generations until certain factor maintained. We call this life cycle is alteration generation, or said to be dormancy stage, latent stage we call. If a viral particle become entered into that the host cell, there may be alteration of the host cell that remain latent, incorporation of the genetic material into that of the host cell, and remain dormant in the latent. If certain factor become maintained further, it can convert into that of the disease form, infected one. There is infection stage here. The cycle is, there is lysis one. They can burst the host cell membrane and release by exocytes, the one that you call chronic release, to be infect another host cell. The key difference is, there is disease one, bursting host cell and release by a chronic release to infect another this one, whereas this one can remain for many generations until certain factor maintained and convert to that of a lytic means. This is a critical difference between what binds lytic and the lysogenetic life cycle of bacteriophage. Well, another topic that we are going to see is HIV in AIDS. HIV is a causative agent, whereas AIDS is a collection of symptoms. Student, do you know what is the difference between HIV positive and HIV negative to me? Well then, to me HIV positive, there is a viral or HIV in contact with a blood of that individual. When you say HIV negative, for 3 consecutive months test, it may be free from that of HIV in contact. As we have seen earlier, under classification of virus, a virus that causes AIDS is grouped under retrovirus. It contains RNA as genetic material. Obviously, RNA cannot be transcribed itself. The exceptional organism that can convert RNA to its DNA is this retrovirus. It can capable to mutate itself because of the presence of reverse transcriptase enzyme. Once a virus, this virus, enter into that of an individual, they insert their RNA genetic material where reverse transcriptase enzyme converts RNA into that of DNA. By that we say it is reverse transcriptase enzyme. This virus affects the CD4, an immune coordinating cell. We call it is said to be CD4 T lymphocyte. They are said to be T helper cells because they are involved in mounting or coordinating immune system to defend against pathogen. They give response against pathogen. A microorganism that infects itself to develop infectious disease, they coordinate together to be defend against them. One critical thing here you must be identify here is there is a special protein called glycoprotein 120 on the surface of this retrovirus. This is a spike that is found on the surface of viral particle that can bind complementarily with the CD4 of an individual. Once this virus becomes bind together, it can capable to further merge to that of the inner or next stage of the cycle. It can proceed to that of the next stage. Here, binding or attachment to that of the host, and again, membrane fusion, which we call entry endocytosis. It means by which they can fuse the membrane CTV, fusing for further goes to that of the next stage. And then after, entry or integration phase. Well done, student. This looks like how the virus in contact with that immune-forming cell of human. This one is what the structure of CD4 looks like. This one is what the structure of glycoprotein 120 of virus looks like. They can receive, there is a receptor cell over this one. A receptor cell to a glycoprotein 120. So here, this can complementarily bind. This one can be complementarily with fit with that of CD4. Well, and after HIV bounds to that of a CD4 receptor of human being of 10%, one, they can fuse the membrane. They can fuse or go to that of the next stage, and they release their genetic matter RNA in the enzyme together. Here, this enzyme is very important in transcription of RNA to that of DNA. Here, RNA can be converted to that of DNA by reverse transcriptase enzyme here. Hereafter, the viral DNA, which is converted here, become incorporated or integrated in that of host genome. In case we are speaking about bacteriophage, host bacterial genome. Here again, the viral DNA become transcribed into that RNA, producing viral protein and enzyme together, which you mean there is RNA reversely transcribed to that of DNA, and again there is a protein, there is RNA. This is the exceptional particle that can capable to transcribe this manner. Then after there is a protein, there is an enzyme here. After this one, the viral RNA, here the viral protein, here the viral enzyme become assembled and escape away from the host cell, either by killing or by chronic release, to be infect another cell. This one is by exocytosis means exocytosis release, releasing of formation of blood and released out of the host cell to infect another one and enter into that of the host cell by means of endocytosis. Well then, student, this can be briefly expressed in this diagram. Once the viral particles containing glycoprotein 120 over them become in contact or attached to that of the host cell, they can enter with that of their genetic material and binds at immune-forming cell. Then RNA become inter together, enzyme become inter together, which is reversely transcribed in that of DNA, forming RNA-DNA hybrid here. Then, the viral DNA formed here become incorporated in that of host genome, in case host bacterial genome, where this host genome DNA become converted to that of RNA. Together, there is a production of protein. Together, there is a production of viral enzyme here. This virus become bad out and released by exocytosis, here by endocytosis entry, and by exocytosis to infect another cell. So, when TLPR cell become reduced, reduction of TLPR cell to mean that the cell unable to coordinate or mount to defend against the pathogen. When the cell immunity forming become reduced here, there is another disease that come together with the reduction of immune system. We call opportunist disease. opportunity diseases are a disease that can bring us to that of death, fatality, as a result of reduction of an immune forming cell. For example, pneumonia and again tuberculosis are a most known opportunity disease that can present together with the reduction of immune system. Well then, student, do you think that there is a drug or vaccine developed in treatment of AIDS? Well done. There is no drug in the vaccine carried out to be give a lasting immunity for AIDS infected. But there are two main drugs given for AIDS patients. These are antiretroviral drug or treatments and HART, the one that we call highly active antiretroviral treatment, which is very effective than HART. Effective. This one is very effective than ART because it contains the combination of this ART. The two main aim of providing drug for individual patient with that of AIDS is blocking the viral progress from one stage to another. Well, generally, in our today's lesson, the one thing that biologists become carry out a controversy with is to group virus either into that of prokaryotic, living, or eukaryotic. And they conclude as it is found between a boundary of living and non-living. Outside a living cell, virus is considered as a particle. Virus show a variation in way they can express, in way they can infect host cell. Based on their genetic material, we can classify virus as that of DNA virus, RNA virus, and the retrovirus. And again, we can group into that of plant infecting, animal infecting, and the bacteria infecting virus. This is all about today's lesson. In our coming lesson, we will start new unit, ecology. Until that, goodbye, students.